In this lecture, we are going to discuss about modified condition decision coverage, which is part of structure-based testing. So first we will see the theoretical concept of modified condition decision coverage. So first understand the theory, and then to get more clarity, I will explain you with an example. So what is modified condition decision coverage? Modified condition decision coverage achieves decision condition coverage, but then requires the following also to be fulfilled. So the first thing which we have to achieve is the decision coverage. That means if there is a decision, we have to make that decision true once, and then we have to make a decision false once. Also, it has to achieve the condition coverage also. So how many conditions are there? All those conditions has to become true and false. So we have to make decision true and false, we have to make condition true and false. Other than that, we also have to fulfill these three conditions. The first condition is at least one test where the decision outcome would change. So we should have at least one change where the decision outcome will change. How it will change? If the atomic condition were true. So when the atomic condition is true, it should influence the decision. So it should make the decision true or it should make the decision false, but it should influence the decision. Similar way, at least one test case shall be there so that the outcome will change if the atomic condition were false. So we have to make, if there is one atomic condition, we have to make that atomic condition true once, we have to make that atomic condition false once. And whenever we are making it true, it should influence the decision. And similar way, whenever we are making it false, it should also influence the decision. And last one is, each different atomic condition has test that meets the requirement 1 and 2. So if you have more than one condition, one atomic condition, then for all the atomic condition, you have to make true and false, and it should influence the decision. So this is what they are talking as per the theory. I know that it is a little bit confusing, and to visualize it in a proper way and to understand this topic, what I will do is I will give you a practical example in the next video. Right now what you have to see is there is one more important point before we proceed further. Assuming n unique atomic condition, so there are n unique atomic condition, then in order to achieve modified condition decision coverage, you need n plus 1 unique test cases. So if you have 5 atomic conditions, then you need 6 test cases to achieve modified condition decision coverage. So this is all about the theory now. And now let's see the example of modified condition decision coverage. Suppose this is a code which is given to you. You can see that how many atomic conditions are here. So you have 3 atomic conditions and 1 modified condition decision coverage. So this particular line will be called as modified condition decision coverage or a decision coverage. So you have to make this particular statement true and false. Then A, B, C will be called as atomic conditions. Now in order to achieve decision coverage, we have to make this decision true and false. And to achieve atomic conditions, we have to achieve or condition coverage, we have to make A true and false, we have to make B true and false, and we have to make C true and false. And whenever we are making this true and false, it should influence the decision also. So combining all these things, it will be classified for modified condition decision coverage. And now let's see how. So this is the first thing which you should know. If you have n unique atomic condition, then you need n plus 1 unique test cases. Okay, so this is clear. So if you have 5 atomic condition, you need 6 test cases. In our example, we have 3 atomic conditions. So we need only 4 test cases. And I will show you how to write those 4 test cases. So here you can see there are 4 test cases. Then here there are 3 atomic conditions. And at the final output, you have a decision. So depending upon this atomic condition, we will see what is the change in the decision. Suppose you are making A as true, then you are making B as false, and then you are making C as true. So what should be your decision? Let's see that. A is true and B is false. So true or false is true. Okay, the outcome of this part will be true. Then true and true is also true. So the final outcome will be true. Now let's see the second test case. False, A is false, B is true, C is true. False or true is true, true and true is also true. So final outcome will be true. Now let's see the third example or third test case. This is false, this is also false, this is true. False or false is false finally, and false and true is also false. Coming to test case 4, true and false. So this is true and this is false. So true or false is true. C is false. So true and false is finally false. So this is the test case we have written. So there are four test cases we have written because we need only four test cases to cover three atomic conditions for modified decision condition coverage. Now let's see about the atomic condition A. So we will discuss about the atomic condition A now, and we will see how influencing the value of A will influence the decision coverage. So we have to consider test case 1 and test case 3. Okay. So what I will do is I will take test case 1 and I will take test case 3, and I will just remove test case 2 and 4 so that there is no confusion when we are analyzing. Test case 1, if we see, A is true and the output is true. So if you see A, so this is what we are talking about, atomic condition A. A is true and then the decision is also true. If we see test case 3, A is changed to false. A was true, now it is changed to false. Holding other values unchanged. So if you see these values, they are unchanged. So B was false, it is still false. C is true, it is still true. So these values are not changed. So holding other values unchanged, the result turns to false. So if you see the result, it is false. So you are not changing anything. You are only, the only thing which you are changing is the atomic condition A. A became true, then it became false, and it resulted in the final output true and false without changing the other value. So this is what is multiple condition decision coverage. Okay. Similarly, now we will try to analyze condition B. So for condition B, we will take test case 2 and test case 3. So this is test case 2, this is test case 3. And now let's remove the other test cases. When B is true and the output is true. So this is B. When the B is true, output is true. When B is changed to false, holding other values unchanged. So you can see that the value of A is false, false. The value of C is true and true. But the value of B when changes, it also affects the result. Other values are unchanged, the value of B is changed, and this change has resulted change in the decision. Now let's try to understand the condition C. For condition C, we will see test case 1 and test case 4. So this is test case 1, this is test case 4, remove test case 2 and 3. Now if you analyze C, you can see that C is true, then the output is true. C is false, the output is false. And if you see the other inputs, that is A is true, true, B is false and false. So other values are unchanged, and change in the condition C has resulted a change in the decision. And this is how you have to do a modified condition decision coverage. So what we have learned finally is, if there are three atomic conditions, there will be four unique test cases. That is it from this particular topic, and I will see you with the next topic. Until then, happy testing.